Honorable Minister Carlson, Excellencies, Ministers, Laureates, Ladies and Gentlemen, it is with honor and much enthusiasm I welcome you to Stockholm today and to the World Water Week 2012. As Mayor of Stockholm, I of course follow with great interest the important work being done by all of you here. And I also want to say congratulations and most welcome to Mr. Torgny Holmgren to your new most important position in service of the world water. It may be hard to imagine today, but Stockholm was at one point one of Europe's most polluted cities. The skies were once covered with gray smoke from burning coal, and the waters were highly contaminated. Disease spread easily, and life expectancy was very low. Today, Stockholm can proudly call itself one of the world's cleanest and healthiest capital cities. And clean water is the city's most valuable natural resource. But we know from that background the importance of long-term work for clean water and air. We also have the important experience of cooperation between academia, research, companies, organizations, individuals, and the political level. And saying the political level, of course, we all think of both national and international level, but never forget the importance of the local level, what the local level both can and must do in these matters. And to that background, of course, it was natural for the city of Stockholm to be engaged both in the founding of the Stockholm Water Prize and then the Stockholm Water Institute. The city of Stockholm was built here strategically over 750 years ago. It was established here with the knowledge that water surrounding the city would act as good defense at that time against possible enemies. But even at that time, but also a most valuable pathway for trade and integration with the rest of the world. Sweden has throughout history been an innovative and trade-oriented nation. Great Swedish scientists and inventors have contributed immensely throughout history and continue to do so. The successful environmental efforts that have been made here in Stockholm can hopefully also be exported and bring inspiration to other parts of the world. Clean and safe water is the key to solving many of our planet's most devastating health problems. Securing clean water is both a local and global responsibility, as I said. I am therefore extremely pleased so many dedicated people, such as you, are here this week. Humankind has always had two natural instincts, survival and curiosity. Water has played a vital part, fulfilling both these instincts. Besides being needing for survival, the oceans made us curious of what may lay beyond the horizons. We set sail to explore the new worlds, and yes, the Vikings discovered America first. As we sailed around the world, we learned more about our planet, realized that it wasn't flat, and started trading with each other. After we discovered the world was round, we set our next goals towards space. It took almost 1,000 years after the Vikings discovered what they called the Vineland before man set foot on the moon for the first time. As our curiosity and explorations extend focuses on other planets and solar systems, water still plays a key role. This is because the search of new life starts with the search for water. Imagine the excitement among scientists if a single, just a single drop of water could be found on the planet Mars. A couple of weeks ago, the latest Mars rover successfully landed on the red planet. As I suppose many of you may know, the Mars rover is brilliantly named Curiosity. Its most important mission is to find evidence that water may have existed on the planet's surface. It may still exist underneath the surface, along with living organisms. Such a discovery would give us new, groundbreaking scientific knowledge of Mars, which we once referred to as the dead planet. As we travel in search for water in space, we shall also treasure it here at home. And that is what this week is all about. Many new innovations, strategies, and collaborations show a promising future for the world's water situation. But still today we know that a lack of water causes problems and even death. This year's World Water Week will address the importance of water and food security. Even though many of today's agriculture practices have a negative environmental effect, particularly on water quality, I'm sure that this is a challenge we can overcome if we just listen, learn, and cooperate. Ladies and gentlemen, with these words, I would like you to wish you all the best during this week in Stockholm and this year's World Water Week. Again, warmly welcome to Stockholm. Thank you very much.